the fish will bite.
What effects of passion? You've heard my daughter tell you?
She did indeed.
How? How I agree. I thought her spirit had influence against all assaults of affection.
I could have sworn it had, my lord. Especially against Benedick.
I should have faced the role of the white people that was speaking. Maybe not fear to hide itself in such reverence.
He's taken the infection. Hold it up!
Hath she made her affection known to Benedict?
No, and she never will. That's her torment.
She did indeed, so your daughter says. Show on, says she. So often can I hear a scorn. Write to him that I love him.
Says she when she's beginning to write to him. For she'll be up 20 times a night, there sitting as fast as you have been in the children.
You took her a sheet of paper. I remember pretty just, your daughter told me.
Oh, when she has written and read it over, she found Benedict and written between the sheets.
That.
Oh, she tore the letter into a thousand happies, railed at herself that she was so immodest, she would love somebody she knew of love. I miss him. By my own spirit, for I, she thought when she writes to me.
Then down upon her knees she falls, weeps, sobs, tears her hair, prays, curses. Oh, sweet Benedict, God, give me patience.
She doesn't weep. My daughter says so. Though the ecstasy sometimes has overborne her.
It were good that Benedict knew it by some other, she will not discover it.
To an end, he may burst forth of it and torment the poor lady worse.
And he should, for in all things. She is an excellent, sweet lady, and not to fall suspicion, she is virtuous.
And she's exceeding wise.
Everything but loving Benedict.
Oh, my lord. Wisdom and blood convening into such tender a body, where we have ten proof to one that blood is victory. Oh, I am sorry for her, for I am forced to be her uncle and guardian.
Would she have bestowed this knowledge upon me, I would have knocked all the respects made of half myself.
Very good. Thank you.
Hugh says surely she would die, for she says she would die if you make her love known, and she would die if you woo her rather than take one breath of her accustomed crossness.
She doth well, she should make tender of her love. It is very possible, he'll scorn, for the man, as you know all, hath a contemptible spirit.
He's a very proper man.
He hath indeed good outward happiness.
Before God, in my mind, very wise.
He doth indeed tristful sparks of like wit.
And taken to be valiant.
As Hector, I assure you, and in the managing of quarrels, you may say he is wise. For either he avoids it with great discretion, or undertakes with most Christian-like fear.
Well, if he does fear God, then he must necessarily keep peace. For if he breaks the peace, then he's out to enter into a quarrel of fear and trembling.
And so will he do. But the man doth fear God, howsoever it seems not by some large jest he'll make. Well, I'm sorry for your niece. Shall we take Benedict to tell him of her love?
Never tell, my lord. Let him wear out good counsel.
Nay, she will wear her heart out first.
Well, we will hear further by your daughter. Let it cool a while. I love Benedict well, and wish he had modestly examined himself and realize how unworthy he is of so good a lady.
My lord, dinner is ready. Would you walk?
If you do not do it upon this, I'd never trust my expectation.
But to be the same next to the blood, that was your daughter and her gentleman kiss. Spoil me.